we've been hearing about scaling agile and all this Kanban. The first thing that we have already heard about this is to improve is to change and to be perfect is to change often. These are the lines also been told by a famous and personally that Winston Churchill. So hello everyone, I'm Rahul and today I'll be taking you to the journey of Agile, how BMC transformed from traditional to Agile and from Agile to scale Agile. Basically, we all know how exactly the human race has been transformed from being Homo sapiens to the one that we are today. Okay, so we'll just go through the journey that BMC had. So I would request everyone to just sit back, relax, and let all of us go through this journey. Before we start, let me tell you something about BMC. BMC is a global leader in providing innovative solutions that enables the business to transform and monitor their digital enterprise. Some key facts. We have 10,000 plus customers worldwide. We have 470 patents granted or pending and with 35 years of IT experience and you can do monitoring space. We have 6,000 employees in 30 countries. So that means we have a global presence. And I'll be talking about touching this point in the presentation also. So we have 500 partners serving to mid-sized companies to major companies, which also include the Fortune 500 organizations. BMC is a 2 billion revenue company. So let's go ahead with the Agile journey. So first thing is what we've already seen is when we came out from our academies or from our colleges, we had learned about the traditional way. Because way back when I was into the college, somewhere around 2000, because I've never heard about scale or agile or scrum or any of these things. What we have learned as per the SEI, the Software Engineering Group, we have a traditional way where we have SDLC, where we have spiral model, where we have iterative model, so all these kind of things, the prototyping model. But we never knew about these things. So the thing is, if you don't change, you would not be, your business would be in danger. So this is a traditional way wherein we see like you go to requirements, from requirements to design, then the coding, the testing, implement, deploy, and maintenance. Everywhere it drops down, you never see it going back. So this is very rigid. We all know you cannot go back from the implement and deploy, you cannot go back to requirement analysis. It never had that channel to go back and do some changes. I'd like to share a video. All the videos and whatever we have been taken from YouTube and Google. Okay, so what is the takeaway from this video?
together it, very simple.
Yeah. It's not pointing out the problems that we had with SDLC or the traditional ways, but yes, there were many pitfalls. And this was one of them, a classic example, wherein the requirements what the customer had might have changed across the time when the development was going on, and what we delivered was of no use to the customer at that moment of time.
Feedback of each phases were not there.
Yeah. Anything else?
Actually, at every level, the information passed is distorted, so everyone's imagination about that information is incorrect.
Loss of information.
Was implemented incorrectly everywhere. Everywhere, I agree. Everything is lost.
So there was a central authority who was controlling things. The requirements manager, the manager was there. He used to give the requirements. That is what used to follow. I remember, I had been in this journey. Way back, we started off with 2004. At 2004, we started off with the Agile journey. We started the first project in 2004 with Agile. That was basically Scrum. So we know, I still remember, we used to find, at the end, we used to sign a document. Like, okay, this stage is complete. I used to sign it. Used to go into escrows. That document was taken, the digital copy was taken and used to go into the escrows, which was maintained as per along with the source code. Let's move ahead. The basic challenge that BMC had at that time was to deliver faster with higher quality than ever. So earlier to going back to 2001 and 2003, we had releases which was spanned across 12 months to 18 months. Traditionally, all the organizations used to do it because this is an enterprise solution. It's not a single solution or a single application. It was an enterprise solution, so it used to take 12 to 18 months. But keeping the customer wait for 18 to 12 months, and at that time we had the monopoly, we had the market, so it was okay. But now when the market grew and there were competitors, it was not possible to have this length of the release cycle with very new. Keep the customer waiting for 12 to 18 months, and till that time you never know if the customer has adopted something new or has changed the way that he was going to implement it. So the basic thing was we had to come up with this, and the basic challenge with BMC was we had 10,000 employees, but at that time we had 6,000 employees, and along with that also to start off with this project, we started with a pilot project. So we started this in the IMG, that is Infrastructure Management Group. So the challenge over here was again, this was spread across 5 countries and people were in 11 time zones. So I would just like to know from the experts of Scrum, how can you come up with a Scrum meeting wherein the people are in 5 countries, different continents and 11 time zones? A single Scrum meeting. How can you do it? So these are some of the implementation challenges we had. Yeah.
See, basically it depends on the mutual agreement, right? All the 11 time zones, obviously you can't accommodate, one person accommodating all, everyone to get together at one point. But with the mutual agreement, say for a few sprints or in a traditional way for a few releases or a duration of months, we come in at this time early to office or late to we stay back or vice versa. So with that kind of mutual agreements, I think you can still have a handshake and have a common meeting with whatever time zones you have.
Yeah, very well said. So that we had tried with Houston and India. So the other challenge was with people in Austin, with Israel and the other continents. So wherein it was very difficult for them to either come early or stay late. It was becoming very difficult. So there was a solution we came up with. So the other thing was we had to enhance the existing products. In IMG, we had two product lines. One was the Petrol Express, the other was the Petrol Classic. So both of them had their own features. One was with agentless monitoring, the other was monitoring with an agent. So both of them achieved the same thing. So the basic thing was, before the competitors would come up with a new product, BMC thought of doing it itself and coming up with the next generation platform. That was called as an NGP. So the basic challenge what we had is enhancing the successful product, existing product, and with greater quality in a smaller time frame. This wasn't a Snuxworks project, wherein some people come and sit into a room, have some ideas, they come up with, write a code, piece of code, and they ship to the customer. It was a product that was already there in the market. There were thousands of customers to it. I still remember, Credit Suisse was the largest customer at that time. It had 60,000 licenses. for a single product. So just imagine, if we are breaking this product, how much was the damage for the company as well as for the product, and in terms of revenue, the brand value and everything. Definitely, BMC ventured into something and they really gained out of that. What we gained was highly engaged team. So at that time, when we started off with Scrum, we had a team which was responsible for its own component, not for the product. People before that were working on the product lines. Just to name it, we had petrol agent, we had knowledge module. So people were responsible only for their product lines. So in that product line also, we had a team of people who are developers, who are QAs, who are IDD from the documentation and from the support. So what used to happen is, okay, the development task has done, so they are sitting idle because there's no new requirement that has come in. So they don't work on anything apart from the escalations or the customer POCs, and the testing is going on. So the testing is going on, at that time the IDD would work along with them because the things have been finalized. So if anything is changing, we cannot change. That has to be the same as it is, as in the requirement specs. So after we came up with Agile, there was a team which used to take their decisions, okay, that something needs to be changed, the customer's requirements have changed, no, we cannot ship this, we need to change it to some other thing. So we were ready to accept the changes. So we had a highly engaged team over there. What we saw is productivity increased from 20 to 50% from individual and the team perspective. We have been talking about the waste. So we have to reduce the production waste. And what do we mean by production waste? For example, we had started an application for monitoring SAP module. Okay? So this project or this application was supposed to take 12 months. What happened in between is SAP itself said we will not be releasing the product. So till that time, it was 6 months down the line, and we have already invested 6 months of time, resources, money and everything, and what we heard is SAP is not going to come up with that product. So all these things were wasted. If we would have done this in Inspire or the Agile model, we would have come to know about this much earlier than 6 months, and we would have reduced this waste, or we would have come up with a new product itself. Yeah, what benefit we saw is frequent releases with critical functionalities. So before, in the traditional manner, we had 12 to 18 months that was required for a product release. And when we came up with Agile, we had 3 to 4 releases in a year. So what we used to do is we used to completely follow Agile, take up the features, functionalities, break them up into a runway, and then have those things implemented and give frequent releases to the customer. The benefit was we used to get early feedbacks in case if there is something that we need to change or we need to modify or we need to come up with something new that was implemented depending on the triage of the requirements in the next release. So rapidly, you see rapidly the new requirements were also incorporated. This was a benefit. Yes, but
so
the thing is...
Question here, Rahul. This is Agi. I wanted to say that when you are going through this phase, when you are saying it's purely Agile, so your teams are working in Agile. What about the layer above that, or the layer above that? Were they still Agile or they were still in the waterfall?
No, they were still in the Agile.
They were also in Agile?
Yeah, they were in the Agile.
Okay. So you did not scale up, but you were still working in Agile,
yeah,
in silos?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. So this was a pilot project only with 300 employees,
okay,
out of all the 6,000. So we did not have it implemented across BMC.
Okay.
It was a pilot project we took up with a small user group, that is IMG, and we just saw the journey and the success.
Okay.
And then it was applied to the other groups, and then we came to the Agile, scale Agile.
Okay.
So definitely when we say about these success stories, there were some challenges. So the challenges was, like, there was a dispersed team. I'm not sure you guys are able to read it. So a dispersed team across 4 countries and 11 time zones. So it was very difficult for us to come up with a scrum time or with the meetings or with the responsibilities of which module or which product would be owned by which team and which area or at which location. The other was, even we tried up with that thing. So the basic challenge is there was a large scrum team. What Agile says is you should not have a scrum team more than 5 to 9 members. We have 30 members scrum team. Very difficult. We definitely have come across, everyone in our life have, in this corporate world, we have come across this thing, like, okay, you are given a responsibility, you are supposed to work on something tomorrow morning, you get a mail in the night, okay, you are supposed to work on this escalation because this is a deal on the table, you need to fix this. you're moved out for a firefighting, you come back. So this disturbs the agile scrum team.